Hello everyone, we have Ambassador Harshvardhan Shringla all the way from DC to Silicon Valley right here for the USI SPF Technology and Investment event. Welcome sir to Yo India TV with me Jasleen Khanuja, and what's your reaction and feedback about this event?
Well, it's obviously an event that has brought together some of the most representative companies and individuals in the Silicon Valley. Mm-hmm. I'm happy to be part of that exercise along with our Consul General Master Sanjay Panda and our other colleagues. I think it was wonderful to have that conversation with John Chambers, who is an institution by himself. Mm-hmm. Recently awarded the Padma Bhushan, one of our highest civilian awards. It was also very, very useful for me to interact with so many members of the high technology community in Silicon Valley. As I said, this is the happening place. This is the place where we really need to be. I'm happy to come, as you said, all the way from DC to be here to engage with people in the Valley.
So we saw that you met president of the country and you made your presentation. How was your experience and what next on the Indo-US bilateral move?
Well, you know, within 2 days of my arrival, I got an appointment with the president to present my credentials. I believe it is unparalleled because otherwise the wait is much longer. The president was very warm and effusive, and he told me that he greatly valued relations with India. Since then, of course, it's been a fairly intense period of meeting a lot of our partners and interlocutors. I was very, very pleased with the sort of receptivity I got everywhere I went. Obviously, there is a lot of importance attached to relations with India, whether you go to Congress, whether you're meeting with think tankers, whether you're meeting with the media, businesses. It is a relationship that has attained a certain level of prominence and is there to stay.
Awesome. So recently we have had a lot of tense relationship with Pakistan, which is continuing for many years. And now it has come to a different point with the recent events in the background. What's your take on that?
Well, I think, the message is clear that terrorism does not pay. The international community has come out strongly in support of India. The United States took the lead in that, and if you saw that it was not just the White House, it was not just the State Department, but 64 congressmen and senators were absolutely clear in their condemnation of this heinous act of terrorism from across the border. It also called on Pakistan to stop supporting terrorism and to providing safe haven to terrorists. At the same time, most of them felt that it reinforced the need for greater counterterrorism cooperation with India. This has been replicated across the board. Even those countries that are sympathetic to Pakistan's viewpoint find that the evidence is so overwhelming and international opinion is so much in absolute certainty that Pakistan is in contravention of every possible international rule and regulation. Pakistan is today, as our External Affairs Minister Srimati Sushma Swaraj said, is virtually isolated in the international stage. And I think what is important is that the international community needs to continue to press on Pakistan to stop its support to terrorism, to dismantle the terrorist infrastructure that emanates from its country. And until that is done, we will not see a stop to this particular situation.
So you've been an ambassador in Bangladesh, an ambassador in Thailand, and now you are representing India in the United States. So what next can we expect, and what's your message to Yo India TV viewers?
I think I would say one step at a time. Let's take it as it comes. Mm-hmm. But thank you so much for giving me this opportunity to address your viewers, and we certainly look forward to engaging with them in the future as well.
Thank you, sir. Have a good
one. Thank you. Thank you.